The year 2022 has witnessed a number of incidents on the security scene. Among them are several attacks on police stations and officers. These attacks have claimed several lives of police officers and civilians, as well as loss of guns. The attacks have been attributed to rebel groups such as the Allied Democratic Forces, ADF, and the Uganda Coalition Forces for Change. Police say with the existence of rebel cells, the country's security is still under threat. Ugandans ought to be extremely vigilant as they celebrate Christmas and the New Year.
Amidst a threat environment that is motivated by individuals and groups with violent ideologies, these criminal elements from the ADF and the Uganda Coalition for Change, UCFC, which is a self-styled rebel group, carried out senseless attacks on police units and personnel, in which some of our police officers lost lives, while others were seriously injured in the line of duty of protecting the community. The sacrifice of our officers will never be forgotten, and their names will be recorded in the Wall of Fame at the police museum.
Enanga explains that the ending year has been quite challenging in terms of fighting crime. However, the force has managed to dismantle a number of criminal cells that have been terrorizing Ugandans.
We restored sanity along the Kampala Northern Bypass. We dismantled criminal networks in the greater Kampala suburbs, notably of Nansana, Chebando, Chengera, Namungona, Katwe, Chisenyi, as well as in the upcountry cities of Mbarara and Fort Portal. We also disrupted efforts by the ADF to reconstitute and establish operational cells in Lukaya and Butambala, and most recently in Matuga and Maganjo. Several suspects linked to the hostile groups were arrested, including the leader of the ADF terror cell in Central Region, Ewan Kabanda Abdallah Musa, alias Mogo.
Meanwhile, the police have revealed that the recently launched operation against military-like actors has registered great success. Over 1,800 military-like actors were recovered within a period of 3 weeks. These had been voluntarily handed over by the owners.
By the end of phase one, the following items have been collected. We managed to collect a total of 1,865 military attires, police attires, and look-alike or seamless attires. Amongst the items that we gathered, we had trousers, 650 trousers, skirts, 104, shirts, 132, t-shirts, 341, capes, 161, jackets, 207.
Police have now embarked on forceful confiscation of these attires, and anyone found with them will be arrested and prosecuted accordingly.
The police, with the support of sister security agencies, has now embarked on phase two, during which anyone found in possession or use of military or police uniforms or attires that resemble such uniforms will be arrested and charged. We wish to thank the public. The Directorate of Crime Intelligence has come out to thank the public for having supported the operation by willingly handing over thousands of these illegal attires, and the ghetto youth coordinators for having worked closely with the territorial police divisions to ensure the success of the operation.
Rachel Nachwala reporting for the news.